Hello again, I'm Rebecca Oles. Welcome back to my studio at Timesmith Dress History. This video is part three, the final part in a three-part series of videos about the process of drafting a pair of 1760s stays. Part one showed me laying out the basic body block with all of the lengths and circumferences established from a physical measure taken on Sarah using a tape. Like this, with the measurements marked. Then part two went on with drawing out the actual pattern for this particular style of stays. Now here in part three, we're using that master pattern to create another set of the pattern that has all of the pieces separate so that they can be cut out and laid out on the fabrics, and the fabrics then cut out to build the stays. So that's what we're doing in this video, part three of the three-part series. Let's get to it. So here you have it, a set of pattern pieces that Sarah can now use to make a mock-up. As a matter of fact, while I've been editing this series of videos to share with you, Sarah has been making her mock-up. So I am really pleased and excited to be able to give you a little sneak peek, the reveal of her mock-up made using this pattern. So I'll just leave you here with a couple of photos that she's shared. We do have a couple of minor tweaks that we are going to do so that she can then crack on with making her final pair of stays. I'm really excited to see how these stays come together for her and how form the basis for making new gowns for her historical interpretations.